Hi, Woody What Watcher, and welcome back to Football Manager and a doubleheader episode. We have QPR away in the Championship, who find themselves in ninth, targeting, I would imagine, a playoff spot, although they're 11 points behind the playoffs. Might be a little bit of a stretch for them. Followed by the replay of the FA Cup fourth round, this time at Croft Park against Bradford City. Might sound like a bad result. We fielded a weakened team and with a better side, but unfortunately it wasn't to be. Let's crack on. We are in the final day of the transfer window. That's the phrase I was looking for. And we've got a couple of inquiries out, but to be honest, I don't really think there's anyone that's going to be available at our budget for right back, but this young lad, Zifre, has a lot of injury problems, so might not be worth it. And then we've got this guy who is highly unlikely going to join us. Let's crack on. How seriously has your transfer budget been depleted? Big chunk came up for the deals. Oh, I don't think I actually said that, did I? Oh, a low, not too low. Right, okay. That's fine. Club vision. That hasn't upset them, that's fine. Under 18s, registration windows open. Monza sign to sign Prezioso. Oh. I don't think I'm meant to put him on my list anyway. They don't want to sell him. They don't want to sell him either. He's wanted. Not discussing that issue today. I rejected it because they've only offered for fringe. Offer to be regular. Ridge to a do you see striker. It's not bad, but I don't see him as any better than what we've got. Compare him with a certain player called Matthias Rocky. Not much in it. But Rocky is the better player. Kim Harper, Bristol City to Brighton. This is, oh, we did want to go looking for a anchorman as well, didn't we? Let's do that really quickly. I'll be back. Okay, so not really anyone we're that interested in. Plenty we're interested in, but I'm assuming that none of them are that interested in us. How's Volpe got on since he left? Doing alright, but he's playing non-league football, to be fair. Barnsley make an offer for Lewis. Regan Poole, right sided defender, 26. No, thank you. No interest in him. Doesn't look like there's much going on for us. That'll bring us to the end. Shane O'Connor has joined Fulham for 7 million. People just have funds that we have nowhere near access to. Faith and trust. And here we go. Average outlay of 475,000 a week, and we can spend 105. 1.2 million for Crystal Palace. Nathan Wood has gone from Brighton to Wolves. Maximilian Philp has gone from Hull to West Ham. Kim Harper has gone to Brighton from Bristol. 13.5 million spent by Brighton. Money we can only dream of, I'm afraid, at this stage. Squad registration. Might as well register them, why not? Nothing to go fancy in the end. Come on, let's get back to the footy. Goal of the month. That was a good goal, but only good enough for second. Financial update. Lost nearly a million. Mainly due to our transfers. Okay. So huge favourites at QPR. Ogbonumbra is out injured. Oh, actually, hang on a sec. Clear entire team. Right. Following goal. Costa right back. Walcott. Gumbo. Brings Zanella in. Anchorman, I would love to pick Rossiter. I can't. Move. Yep. And then as a volante would be Rossiter. But if we flicked a Regista, it would be Callum Hume. There we go. Now who's going to go down the right? That's right. Demario Wright Phillips. Who's going to go down the left? Kapani. And who's going to play here? Weiss. And then up front, surprisingly, is Rocky. Okay. We then need a defender. Midfielder and midfielder. And Blind, D'Amico, and Broja. Now, what is wrong with him? Suspected food poisoning. Rossiter's still out for ages. I think we'll have to bring in Dreher for both. So Zanella is the only one building up fitness. Price is still one. I'm sure up to his asking price to 10 million. You think Dudeberg would get lost at that point? They haven't though. Okay, that's the team. Come on, let's get a point at least, please. Say at least, I'd be thrilled with a point. Hume has it to Kapani, to Zanella, loses it to Miller. Huddersfield lead at home to Sunderland. Weiss gets an early yellow. The Costa clears. Weiss brings it away. Portsmouth lead at Birmingham. Rocky is in. Oh, great challenge. The ball goes to Kapani. And it's in, but Rocky was offside. Oh, I'm not sure about that, I must admit. That's just... He's certainly onside there. That's where the ball's about to be played. Maybe a few inches off. Unbelievable. DeCosta clears. Weiss to Wright Phillips. Dives inside. Hume. Back to Ogunbo. Have I got all these highlights on the screen? Ogunbo. QPR, Jones has it out wide, he beats DeCosta, he's in the area, floats one, straight at Barlow. Whoever that was, like a world class commentator with the ability to spot players like that. Capani, free kick, whips one in, Walcott with a volley into the side netting. Luton leaded Bristol City. Everyone else looking to pick up points where we can't. A bit more balance now. Wright Phillips throws it to DeCosta. Wright Phillips again. Back to DeCosta. Crosses. McClelland clears. Dreher looks left. Finds Zanella who nips inside. Finds Hume from distance. It's a corner. Capani crosses. Barlow has a goal kick. Weiss flicks it on. Powell back to his keeper. It's Fulham lead at Swansea, so only one game going our way at the moment. Doyle Hayes plays in Miller with a fine finish. And it's 1-0. Walcott gives it away. Trail with a good tackle. Zanella. Ogunbo. Goes back to Barlow. Wright Phillips flicks it on. No one's there. Cochrane brings the ball forward. Jones. Doyle Hayes. Jones. Tipped over by Barlow. Offside. Finished by Todd Miller. The difference between the teams at the minute. Here they come again. Jones has it. Leaps into the area. Block. Swans equalise. Barlow grabs it. And we've got 5 minutes to half time. Throw in Wright Phillips to Weiss. Loses it to Butcher. Weiss dives in, almost gets the ball. If he timed that, he would have been off. Dreher finds Capani, nips inside his man, and it's a poor finish. He could have took another touch, chose not to. And the chance is gone. A minute of injury time before half time. Cochrane to Doyle Hayes. Zanella gets rid of it to Weiss, who gets it back from Hume. Dreher, DeCosta, Dreher, Walcott. Rocky gets it back to Weiss, beats his man, drives towards the box. Inside Wright Phillips, who beats his man, massively tips it over. Would have been some goal. It's a corner. Should be the last attack of the half. Capani to take. McClelland deals, Weiss has it, and the block signals half time. So we'll go back at it. And Weiss will be coming off to be replaced by DeMarco. D'Amico, sorry. Throw in. QPR down the wing. Jones has it. He beats DeCosta. Tell over the top. Oh, he gets a yellow card. Okay, so Weiss is going to come off for Kapani. Sorry, Weiss is going to come off with D'Amico. We'll give Kapani 10 minutes there before we bring on Manvillian. I haven't decided how to pronounce that one yet. D'Amico though wins the header, gives it to Hume. To Kapani, finds D'Amico outside, beats his man, tipped over by Masney. Birmingham equalise against Portsmouth. We can go 2-0 up now with Bristol City. Kapani crosses, Rocky wins the header and Masney gathers it comfortably. Right, Phillips from deep. Walcott almost gets up ahead of Masney. He goes long. Zanella wins the header. Hugh, Agongo. Rocky has it. He's gone on his own. Strikers straight at Masney. Huddersfield 2-0 up now against Sunderland. That helps us. Howe throws it into Miller. Byraktar. Oh, Jones again. Miller. Oh, it's a good save. Nope, it actually hit the post. Right, so. Right, Phillips is going to make way for Broha. Give it a little bit and then Rocky might have to come off. Forest equalise against Rotherham. Yeah, so D'Amico's going to go up front and Rocky is going to come off for the attacking midfielder. Minutes to go. Kapani, really dangerous free kick. He scored. What a free kick. Yards. Oh, wonderful. Right on the top corner. He's here for the season. Corner for QPR. Away by Walcott. We need to Ambrose. Jones, how scores the winner. Oh, terrible. We're still celebrating the goal. I don't quite understand how we've got so little resilience. 5 minutes to go. Huddersfield 3-0 now against Sunderland. Doyle Hayes, one of the post. Time running light, 3 minutes to go. De Costa to Walcott. Looks down the lane, gives the ball away to Jones. Walcott gives it now to Manvillian. Miller brings it away. Howe tries to cross, he does. Walcott away. Only to Doyle Hayes. Tribal puts it wide from 25 yards. Here's Brewer, hasn't really been in the game since coming on. Gives it to Hume. Beats his man. Don't know what that was, but he's won a corner from it. 90 seconds, Kapani crosses, a gumbo! Oh, wonderful header, but tipped over. The next one cleared by the defender. The gumbo has it. To Dreher. Dreher again. Back to Zanella. Gives it away to Cochran. Down here, brings it clear. Plays it Ambrose, wide of the post. He's offside anyway. 5 minutes of injury time to play. Three of them remain. Masner. The Costa misses his header. Walcott gives it back to Barlow. He gives it to a Gunmo. Gunmo goes long. Damico Conn in the header. Dial Hayes gives it to Jones. They call QPR. Cost. Barlow, sorry, tips it over from Ambrose. 2.5 minutes left. After this, away by Walcott, Brewer, it's clear. Minute to go, 30 seconds left. QPR have the ball. Zanella goes long. D'Amico is in. Oh, it's a great tackle by Cochran. He concedes the corner. That was a chance. It's away by Howe, and that'll be full time. D'Amico must have thought he had a great opportunity there, Da Costa to Manvelian. QPR win the ball, and that should be the final whistle, and is another really narrow defeat, undeserved. The goal from Capani was absolutely outstanding. How we haven't come away with something, I don't know. Just need that little bit of belief back in the team, I think. Luton win, Portsmouth draw. Sunderland got hammered and go bottom. Swansea drew. So now only 2 points clear of the relegation zone. Wow, how this season has changed. Right, Bradford up next in the cup. I think we need to get a win under our belt. Ahead of the Swansea game. And Bellion scores. Move back to fitness. See, so scores again. Scored 4 in 3 games for them. What a player. Newcastle grab a draw against Chelsea. Climb to 16th. Croft Park ready for a spectacle. Bradford City sending 2,500 fans. Press conference. Long held tradition. Okay, they made good. Yep, prepared. Yep, we're going to get a result. Oh, that's a surprise, as being expected. Right, so we're just going to tweak this team rather than have much change going on. I can't understand what's wrong with this guy. Why is he unhappy? Kapanian team of the week. Alan goes and does his thing. Also beat Reading. Here we go, televised. For a while, so Nella's gonna have to continue. I think we'll start Demico ahead of Kapani. Manvillian will get a game. Broha in for Wright Phillips. Walcott from McGlaw. And Bove will miss out because he's still a yellow card away from suspension. But that's actually only in the FA Cup, so we don't want to risk it because we want to play against Everton should we win. Barlow obviously can't play, so he's out for him. And then Gregory in for Barlow. Perfect. Let's go. Tunnel. Bro handed a rule that doesn't suit him. And let back a class if we highlighted it. Here goes. That was comfortably. Broha wins a throw. Broha brings it down the right. Crosses. Oh, good header. Saved by the keeper. Hume crosses. Broha's up there. Oh, can't get there. McGlaw back to Hume. Can't beat his man, but gets a throw in. Hume with a free kick. Finds McGlaw on the left. Keeps it in. Crosses. D'Amico. Keeper dive, but it hit the defender. And the keeper worried though. Corner, Hume to take. Dreher, on the Hume, chance to cross, gets into the box. Manvelian scores after a game of human ping pong. Second goal of the season for him. And here's the ping pong. Hume chooses not to cross, gets into the box, passes it to Broha, who strikes it to defender. Hume into the back of the defender in the end. Lawrence and falls to Manvelian to score. 1-0 Blyth. Quarter of the game gone. Well and truly on top. Let's do a bit more tackling, try and finish this game off before half time. Trying to create a little bit of confidence in the team before the Swansea game as well. Rocky has it on the right, looks to beat his man. He does beat his man confidently. Hits the defender with a strike. Hume forces a good save out of Tyra. And it's a corner. Hume crosses away by Birch. Gunbo's going to pick up the loose ball. De Costa with a free kick just inside the Bradford half. Just into play. Hume switches it, finds D'Amico. D'Amico, sorry. Zanella finds him as well. Crosses. Broha wins the header, but he's backpedaling. Hard again, any power in it straight at Tyra. Easy save. Few minutes remain to half time. Minute of injury time to be added, and that is all they wrote. Absolutely slaughtering them, but only 1-0. Capacity crowd. Hopefully watching us progress to the fifth round away at Everton. Tyra. Broha takes the ball off a longer. He's got Rocky inside him. Crosses, finds Rocky, who blasted into the net, but is offside. That must have been marginal. Not even sure, does the ball travel? Yeah, it does travel forward. He is half a step offside. Throw in to Bradford. Crossed in. Moved by De Costa. And as far as Alunga. And Dennis. And rather tame measure by Carl. Straight at Scott. D'Amico not having a good game. We approach the hour mark. He's going to make way for who for? It would be Capani, and why not? Then we're also going to bring Dreher on now for Dreher. Bradford, point blank range, Scott Wall gone. Well, 15 minutes to go, it's on a bit of a knife edge because I've absolutely slaughtered them, but it's still only 1-0. The goal goes long to Rocky, who finds Capani, who's going to cut inside, yes he does, and then almost a back pass to Tyra with that little power in it. 10 minutes to go, and Broha makes way for Wright Phillips. A gumbo. Finds Broha down the right. Beats his man. Has the ball. Hits the defender and it's a corner. That will be his last involvement. Capani. Wright Phillips trying to score with his first touch. And such luck. 7 minutes to go. Ogungbo to Zanella. To Ogungbo. To McGlaw. To Wright Phillips. To Costas out wide. He doesn't need him. He does now. Chance to cross. He plays it inside. Instead, Capani with a finish that hits the defender yet again. Zanella trying to torment the defender who clatters into him. 6 minutes to go. Capani with a free kick. Bounce to nothing. And Valian has it. Crosses. Rocky! Oh, wonderful left foot volley from Rocky. Looked like the ball had been overhit. How he's managed to finish, I do not know. Van Velien gets the ball, hoops it in. It's gone way past the goal. Angle is narrow. Soal keeps his head down and swings a left peg at it. 2-0 and the game is dead. The folk in Bradford, they are done. Not a bad performance though by the non-league side over the two legs, but they've been well beaten and we're quite fortunate to get the replay, to be fair. Absolute thumping. Rocky getting man of the match for that awesome finish. And an away tie against Everton. 200 grand for winning that, 70 grand for the TV appearance, and we'll have got 60 grand for the attendance, so not a bad little money spinner. In fact, was that all? Our first home game of the month, so we can see exactly what it was worth. 200 grand in prize money, 72 grand in TV revenue, and 73 grand plus 11 grand plus 8 grand. So all of that's about 25,000. Call that 100. It's about 300 grand on that game. Good stuff. What I didn't do is see what that actually did to our balance. Is that about the 5 million mark? That's pretty good. Could Blyth on as good as they think? Well, that's better. The fairy tale continues. Must be delight to progress further. Get ahead of ourselves. Big up Rocky. Right decision. There we go. So we've got Everton coming up. Them to the TV fixtures, so might have a chance of getting on the telly, who knows. Raise a smile to it. It's got a little bit left to learn about football at this level for me. Right. little bit patronising, but who cares? Record total. Swansea City up next, and what has to be a must win for us, given that we're at home. Swansea are favourites though. Confident mood, momentum's fantastic. Not going to comment on the other game. Touch and go. Come on, Ian. Go and do your thing. Dyke steel. Press your saw. Cavallo. Demaka. Turnbull. And that's it. That's the end of the week, end of the episode. Next time out, we have a vital home game against Swansea, followed by an away trip to Barnsley, who are mid-table. And then following that, we've got a one game week, at home to Nottingham Forest, who are mid-table. And then we're back to our usual two games a week, away at Portsmouth and at home to Middlesbrough, followed by away at Luton and away at Everton in the FA Cup fifth round. So lots to play for in the next six league games before we have our attention deferred to the FA Cup. Join me for Swansea at Croft Park next time around. Till then, stay safe. Bye-bye.